I'm Dr. Elena Maganto, and I'm really thankful for Treehouse to open this workshop because I want to give you some of the best tools to be able to protect your body and fight coronavirus 19, but not just that one, any virus that may be coming at any time in your life, because there are other viruses even more important than this one, like, for example, the virus of the mononucleosis, the Epstein-Barr, that remains in our body for life, and we just need to keep a strong immune system in order to be able to prevent flare-ups. So these are all natural alternative foods, supplements that I want to share with all of you in order to do that. And actually, I'm going to put in the chat, I'm going to be talking about different things, and you will have the recording, but I have created a file. Let me copy in the chat, and I think Treehouse is going to share with you these links later. So this is a landing page that I have created with three of my favorite recipes. It's video recipes that I have created to prepare fermented foods or golden milk that are very good for boosting immunity. And then you have also the file with the list and the links for anything that I'm talking about in here. So it's no brainer. If you don't have, you don't want to be reading labels, I already do the research for you. So, yes, I think I have to click. Okay, yeah, I'm a little bit far from the computer. So, yeah, first I want to start just quickly with the virus is real. We really need to think about the virus that spreads really fast. 2 weeks ago, it wasn't like this here in Hawaii or in United States. But for example, I'm from Spain, and they have been in quarantine already for 3 weeks, complete quarantine, because it's a virus that spreads really, really fast. So instead of complaining about going in quarantine, we have to really see it as an advantage, because the problem is that there are not enough resources at the hospitals, there are not enough breathing machines, so they want to prevent that they have to choose who's getting the machine and who's not, and that is what happened in Spain a few weeks ago. So they had to decide who was getting the machine, and that's very, very sad. So this virus has an incubation time of up to 15 days. In those 15 days, we may not get any symptom. And at that time, you may think that you don't have the virus, so you are spreading the virus around, or you get it from somebody who doesn't know that has the virus. So it's why it's so important to have everybody at least for 2 weeks in quarantine at home, so you develop the symptoms, then you call your doctor, but you are not spreading the virus around or you don't get it. So that's why these precautions are important if we want to prevent it. Then I also want to point out that in the news, they're scaring people that has high blood pressure or diabetes, like they're the most prone to get the coronavirus. It's not just high blood pressure, it's not just diabetes. It's if you have any autoimmune disease, any disorder that can be related to inflammation, your immune system is too busy fighting that disease, so it's not able to fight anything else that is coming from outside. So in general, what is important is to keep a strong immune system no matter what we go through. So instead of getting stressed, because stress releases cortisol and then go to your bloodstream and affects the reproductive system, the digestive system, the immune system, is causing immune suppression, what we have to be is trying to be proactive, learning everything that we can in order to protect our bodies. So probably you hear already about the symptoms, but I wanna, because a lot of people are calling to the hospitals to get the test, but then there are a few symptoms that are different. You have the flu or you have coronavirus. So for coronavirus, you get sore throats and coughing, like mucus coughing. You get really, really high fever. Then the virus goes to the lungs, destroys the lung cells. So you have impaired capacity to share oxygen. and that causes incapacity to breathe normally. You can even get pneumonia, you can get SARS, which is severe acute respiratory syndrome, and a lot of associated disorders. The flu has similar symptoms, like you can get fever, you can get sore throat, you can get GI problems. Now is one of the current symptoms also for coronavirus, that you can end up having some diarrhea as well, some gastrointestinal problems. But the flu has nasal congestion and nasal mucus, and the coronavirus doesn't. So if you do have those symptoms, that is not coronavirus, that is a cold or a flu. So then before we go through foods and supplements, I just want to go briefly through some of the most important things to protect yourself when you are outside your house against the virus. And one is the mask. But if you don't have an N95 mask, it's not really doing anything because the virus can go through. But more important than a mask, do you really want to wear gloves? Because when you go to the supermarket, you are touching carts, you are touching doors, you are touching baskets, you are touching plastic bags to get your products. People have been touching those products. So ideally, you want to wear gloves. Could be surgical disposable gloves, or you can just get regular gardening gloves or of kitchen gloves. So that is important. Then arrive home and try to clean everything. And tomorrow in YouTube, I have a YouTube channel, Elena Maganto, that I'm updating information all the time. I'm launching a video that I tell you how you have to clean everything and what you have to do as soon as you arrive home from outside, or you go to your mailbox and get your mail in order to prevent being infected. But actually, one of the things that you can do is spray everything with a mix that you can make at home with 25 milliliters bleach and 1 liter water. I usually don't like bleach because it's very toxic. It goes through the brain barrier and can cause a lot of issues. But this is a really, really diluted mix because you make it with the 5 to 6% bleach that we all have at home. And it's because bleach is killing the virus in that dilution. So you can spray your things, you can have this at the entrance, or you can have just pure 70% to 90% alcohol. So yeah, these are things that you can have at the entrance of your house in a box. And I explained in that video how to clean everything. Then wash your hands for at least 20 seconds. Don't touch your mucosas, because like the eyes, nose, or mouth, because that is how the virus enters and can end up in your lungs. Try to keep 3 feet distance with a person that may be coughing. Like at the supermarket, they have already put some tape on the floor to let you know that you have to keep at least 3 feet distance. And then when you clean things, consider that the virus is able to stay not in the air, but in surface. In plastic and stainless steel or other metal and hard surfaces can be for 48 hours. In cardboard surface can be for 24 hours. In copper for 4 hours, and in sprays for 3 hours. In our clothing that is not as hard, probably is gonna be a little bit less than 24 hours, but it's not determined. And these times were analyzed by the CDC as well. So those are things that we can do to protect ourselves whenever we are outside from the exposure of the virus and bringing it at home. But then, which are the most important natural approaches that we have to consider to protect your body itself against any virus? So first, the most important is to boost your immune system. The immune system are the soldiers that we have in our body to fight anything, not just a virus, but a bacteria, but toxins coming from the water or the food, anything that is coming from outside. And then the second thing that we have to consider, always really important, is your gut. Yes, your intestines, your gut, your digestive system. Because 70% of your immune system is in your gut. 70. So instead of calling digestive system, we should call it, I would say, immune system. And also it's very important because we have a lot of microbes, a lot of microbes in our gut. And the microbes are the ones responsible for educating, teaching your immune system, strengthening your immune system. So it's why it's really important always to think about your gut and what we put in our body before, when we are thinking about boosting immunity. And because, for example, I saw with the fever of the toilet paper, I went to Costco and then I saw people buying a lot of toilet paper, but then after they were buying the ice cream from Costco, for example, or any other sugary product that is immune suppressing the body. So what we really have to think about is what we can do to have a strong body to fight if we get in contact with anything. So which are the most important foods? And I want to say that anybody can ask any question while I'm talking. You can write it down in the chat so I can answer it. Or after I finish talking, we can have a Q&A and you can ask me anything that you are curious about. So foods, let's talk about foods. So the first is that you need to cut all processed and most important, sugar, because sugar immune suppress your body. Sugar, hydrogenated oils, and environmental toxins like pesticides, hormones, anything coming from the food and the water, all of that we have to eliminate it, processed food, because that immune suppress your body. And then foods that I do recommend is just sticking to the whole foods when you eat. One of my favorite is lemon or lime that I have in here, because lemon and lime are really rich in vitamin C that is amazing for boosting immunity, but also alkalizing your body and cleansing your liver, because if your liver is in trouble, you may not be able to fight very well. So lemon and lime, then hot drinks. The coronavirus has been shown that is not a heat resistance. So drinking soups that are hot, teas that are hot, any hot drink is always really good to protect your body against the virus. And then talking about tea, two of my favorite roots in the planet are ginger and turmeric. You can have them in the powder form, tea form, in powder or tea bags, or you can have the roots. So I recommend everybody that the same we put salt and pepper in our meals, you start putting ginger and turmeric everywhere. But one important thing, whenever you use turmeric, you need to add black pepper, just a little pinch, if you want to increase the bioavailability of the turmeric, the curcumin in our body, and prevent a fast detoxification. So turmeric is really rich in curcumin, ginger is really rich in gingerol. Those are the active compounds that help in boosting immunity and decreasing any systemic inflammation that you may have in your body. So those are some of my favorite. Then garlic. Garlic, you can digest it well because it's a FODMAP and some people cannot digest it. Garlic is one of the best antibiotics of the planet. It's really rich in allicin, which is what is giving the garlic the antimicrobial effects. Then let's see what I have in here. So bone broth. So I made a huge batch. I have several containers of bone broth made with grass-fed beef. You can make it with any kind of bones, chicken, you make the whole chicken in the oven and then with the bones you make the broth and make just a huge batch of it and just keep drinking one cup of bone broth a day. If you don't want to make it, you can also find good alternatives for bone broth at the market, but it's important to read the label. So in the file that I mentioned at the beginning, I put a link for a good bone broth. If you cannot drink bone broth every day, then another really good alternative for it is collagen powder. So why, but buy the multi-collagen powder, not the just the regular collagen powder, because the multi-collagen, you have the 5 types of collagen. The regular collagen powder, you have only 2. So this is stronger. And why collagen or bone broth is because they are really rich in proline and glycine. Proline and glycine are amino acids that are very important for keeping a strong gut, for boosting immunity, and for healing the gut lining if you have some gastrointestinal inflammation. So this is something that everybody should be drinking every single day, or taking one scoop of this every day, which is already 10 grams of protein. Then my other favorite food that you should be incorporating every single day with your meals are fermented foods. Fermented foods are a really powerful way, a natural way to incorporate probiotics, to incorporate microbes. And as I said before, the microbiome in your gut has to be really diverse to teach the immune system, to strengthen the immune system. So you can do pickled kimchi, pickles by itself, any fermented vegetables, sauerkraut. This is a batch of sauerkraut. Sauerkraut lasts in your refrigerator forever. So you can make a huge amount of sauerkraut, and then it's a really good survival food, actually. And yeah, the sauerkraut basically it takes just 5 minutes to make. It's just cabbage and salt. It takes 5 minutes, and then the fermentation during a few days. So it's really, really simple to make, but there are alternatives that I put in the file that you can also buy if you don't want to make your own. And pickled kimchi and sauerkraut and golden milk. Golden milk is a drink that combines turmeric, ginger, cinnamon, that is really good for balancing blood sugar, are three video cooking classes that I have put in the link that I have shared in there. And then beside sauerkraut, one of my favorite fermented foods is kefir. So if you tolerate dairy, you can get a regular milk kefir. I do recommend going more for goat because it's more digestible than the cow or the sheep. But personally, to prevent any gastrointestinal issues, I do recommend coconut water kefir, just made with water or with coconut water. And coconut water has a lot of sugar by itself, but the bacteria is gonna eat it. So there's no way you are putting any sugar in your body. And one tablespoon of this is 100 billion bacteria. 100 billion bacteria. So this is a really potent way to take one tablespoon a day and then keep a really diverse microbiome in your gut. So these are some of my favorite. But then whenever you have to prepare your food and you are eating out, then the main thing that you always have to think is vegetables. Vegetables has to be 50 to 75% of your plate. And the greener, the better, because they're full of antioxidants to fight inflammation. But why it's so important to have vegetables is because in our gut, we have some microbes, like for example, bacteroidetes or clostridium, that ferment fiber. And after the fermentation, it's producing short-chain fatty acids, which are propionate, acetate, and butyrate. So those short-chain fatty acids are really good for feeding the gut lining and strengthening your immunity. So it's why the main thing you gotta focus when you are choosing your meals is vegetables, to provide as much fiber as you can for that. So then going through some of my favorite supplements, there are supplements that are antimicrobial and there are supplements that are good for boosting immunity. The difference between a supplement or the food is that the concentration is much, much higher. For example, for vitamin C, when you take 500 milligrams in one capsule, you need a lot of bags of lemons or limes in order to get to that concentration. So it's why when we really want to be effective, we need to take the supplements as well. So some of my favorite antimicrobial, and that is including viruses, are first oregano or oregano plus clove together. You can take 2 drops of oregano a day. to prevent, or if you are under the weather, you can take 2 drops of oregano, 1 of clove, or just oregano, 2 to 3 times a day in 4 ounces of water. Oregano is not just good antimicrobial, but it's also good for boosting immunity because of the concentration in carvacrol. Then my other favorite, as I said, garlic is really good when you are cooking, but you can also get garlic extract. And please read the labels for supplements, because the supplements, you don't want to find any sugar. And usually when there is a liquid form, there's some sugar in there. So in the link, I already did the research for you. So garlic is really rich in allicin, so perfect for fighting that. Another one is colloidal silver as well, one of my favorite, or olive leaf. Olive leaf is really rich in phenolic acids, which it will give the olive leaf the antimicrobial properties. So just stock any, you don't need to have all of them, just stock any of the best natural antibiotics. But what's the difference between the regular antibiotic or these antibiotics? Why these are effective with a virus and why the regular from the counter antibiotics are not? So it's because the regular antibiotics are diluted in water. When we are fighting a bacteria, the bacteria stays outside the cell. When we are fighting a virus, the virus is inside the cell. So antibiotics that are diluted in water cannot go through the cell membrane. However, can kill the bacteria because it's outside the cell. Because when we have a fat and we have a water, doesn't blend, right? But when we have fat and we have fat, blends. So the outside membrane of our cells is made by fat, by lipids. So it's why a water-based antibiotic cannot go through. However, essential oils are fat. So they are able to go through the cell membrane in order to attack that virus. So it's why these are really, really effective. Then some of my favorite supplements to boost immunity. So the first one, of course, vitamin C. Everybody should be taking all the year long vitamin C, 500 to 1,000 milligrams when you are fasting in the morning, just once a day. This is one of the best. Then the other one is vitamin D3. And even if you live in an area where you have a lot of sun exposure, almost everyone is vitamin D deficient. And vitamin D controls thousands of gene expressions, including your immunity. So if you don't have deficiency, I would maintain with about 2,000 units. If you do have deficiency, you need to take even 10,000 units of vitamin C, D. Then zinc is also a really good supplement to have at home if you are under the weather or you want to prevent to get sick for boosting immunity. Of course, like vitamin C, omega-3 fatty acids are a must for everyone all the year long in order to always keep your immune system strong and decrease any systemic inflammation that you may have around. 1,000 milligrams of EPA DHA for omega-3, that is one of my favorites. And now, and all the stores are running out of it, one of the most popular for boosting immunity is elderberry syrup. This is one of the best as well whenever you are getting under the weather or you want to fight. So taking 2 teaspoons of elderberry syrup 2 to 3 times a day is really, really good. But please read the label, no sugar on the label. And as I mentioned, for fermented foods, you can instead also take or both. I do both now in order to keep always my immune system strong. You can also take probiotic. When you buy a probiotic, it's not that much about the brand, it's about the other ingredients and how potent it is. So a good probiotic needs to have at least 30 billion bacteria and 10 different strains of lactobacillus and bifidobacteria. The more diverse, the better. So you repopulate and get a more diverse microbiome as well in your gut. So yeah, these are some of my favorite. And if you already feel your throat is a little bit scratchy, you can get some sprays that, or just make a tea with it, with echinacea and licorice. Echinacea and licorice are really good for the sore throat or the scratchy feeling that you may have when you are getting a virus. So these are the top foods and these are the top supplements that everybody should stock at home to fight this virus and to prevent getting that virus. But then besides food and supplements, it's also important to work on a couple of routines that are good in your lifestyle. So the best is fasting. Fasting. So fasting, actually, when you are in quarantine, save you money because you don't have to buy that much, and save you time because you don't have to eat that often, right? But the most important about fasting, and we are talking about a 17 hours fast. So when you go longer, like a 24 hours, it's good for decreasing pain and inflammation. However, it has been shown that we have different type of white blood cells. There are some white blood cells that fight viruses. There are some white blood cells that fight bacteria. So the ones that fight bacteria are doing really, really well in a very low glycemic index glucose in your body with a very long fast, even 24 hours or longer. However, the ones that fight virus, they don't like to be in such a low number. So 17 hours is best. Don't go longer than 17 hours fast between your meal, the last meal the day before, and the first meal now. So one of them, you fight virus. That's one of the benefits. The second one is that you repopulate bacteria. The more often we eat and the more processed food we eat, the more we deplete the bacteria in our gut. So giving a rest to the digestive system for a few weeks, doing a 17 hours intermittent fasting, has been shown to repopulate the diversity of the bacteria, including the bacteroidetes that I mentioned before, that is important for producing the short chain fatty acids. And the other benefit is that it's giving a rest to the digestive system, is giving a rest to your liver. If you do the fasting during the night, because the liver works at night between 1 a.m. and 3 a.m. So it's why you don't want to do things that overwhelm the liver, like eating late or having heavy foods before you go to bed. So ideally, fasting 17 hours during the night. So that's one of my favorite lifestyle routines to boost immunity. And the second one is sleep. Yeah, sleep. That's one of my favorite, actually. So why sleep? It's because during sleep, we produce melatonin. And the melatonin is important to counteract inflammation. It's depleting all the free radicals and avoiding the free radical tissue damage caused by inflammation. And also decreases cortisol, and cortisol immune suppresses your body. So why sleep is one of the best medicines, the best therapies that you can do if you want to really keep a strong immunity. And then even during quarantine and you have to stay home, do things that help you de-stressing. And one of the most important is to be away from electronics or be watching the news constantly in your phone, because that, as I said, causes more stress, more release of cortisol, and then immune suppress your body more. Move your body in whatever way you can do from home. There are online yoga classes, there are online classes with weights. One of my favorites personally, and I have put the link in there, is the vibration plate. The vibration plate is a small machine. You don't need to have that huge machine that moves your lymphatic system, your blood circulation, helps with muscle growth, helps in decreasing inflammation, helps in detoxifying your body. 15 minutes of vibration plate is the equivalent to 2 hours of yoga, 2 1 hour running and 1 hour and a half swimming. So a vibration plate is a very efficient way to do exercise at home in a very short time. And then do Epsom salt bath, breathing exercises, things that help you in de-stressing, in calming, in bringing the body into homeostasis, because that is very important when we want to keep a strong immune system and we want to fight. So yeah, I wanted to go through these things today. Thank you, Treehouse, for bringing me here to share all of this. I'm really, really happy to answer any questions that anybody may have. But before, I want to also share that, you know, now we got to be all at home and it's easier to keep learning and keep being proactive from home. So I have created Health on Demand. I'm really thrilled to share this. So Health on Demand is trainings that are happening every single month, every other week. I'm doing live trainings and Q&As and cooking classes, and everybody has the recording, and there are many, many other resources in there. It's a year membership and it's just $27 a month for all that information to keep your body going, to always keep a strong health, and also keep it for a lifetime so you are able to fight anything that may come like this. So I'm very, very happy to share the link for Health on Demand as well here, and I think the Treehouse is going to share it in an email as well. But I'm happy to answer any questions that you may have now. You can put it in the chat or you can open your microphone. No questions. That means I was very clear.
No, I don't have any questions, but I did learn about some of the new types of supplements and what they do a little more in depth as well. So thank you for sharing that.
Yeah, this is, instead of having a cabinet with medications, everybody should start stocking the antibiotics and the immune booster foods like supplements. So then whenever we go under the weather, you can always fight it. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So we have a question here as well from Errol. Thank you for joining, Errol. What is the combination of salt and cabbage? Yes, so we are going to be learning that together. But anyway, the combination of salt and cabbage is, you are going to see it because I'm going to share, I share in the chat here a link where you get access to video cooking classes. And one of them is how to make sauerkraut or pickled kimchi. But the combination is for one head of cabbage, about one tablespoon or one and a half, depending how big it is. But yeah, follow the video because it's pretty straightforward. You can make it at the same time that I make it. And actually, talking about combinations, I want to point out something extremely important that I didn't mention when I talk about the bleach mix. Don't mix the bleach with vinegar, because a lot of people ask me that. So why don't you mix it with vinegar instead of mixing it with water? So it's more efficient, because vinegar is also antimicrobial. When you mix an alcohol with an acid like vinegar, so when you mix bleach with an acid, it releases a gas that is called chlorine. And very high levels of chlorine gas can be toxic for your eyes, for your lungs, and at some point, if it's really high, can be deadly. So don't mix the bleach with the vinegar. Anybody else has a question? I'm gonna copy the link in the chat now for the Health on Demand if you wanna take a look. I just put it in the chat. So we started the live trainings last week. So whoever is joining can already see the recording of that one. And this coming Saturday, actually, we have a live cooking class for comfort foods based on an anti-inflammatory diet, low-carb diet. So we are going to be making pizza that a lot of people ask me for. Of course, it is totally grain-free. And we are going to be making also some hummus and fries that are not starchy-based. So, yeah, I'm really, really excited. How much exercise should you get if you're feeling a little sick? So one of the things that I mentioned, Kino, is that sleep is important when we're talking about immune boosting. So if you are sick, the most important thing that you gotta do is rest. Giving a rest to your body is one of the best ways to fight. But you still need to move your body. So a very slow yoga, nothing too harsh, or doing the vibration plate for 5 minutes. You don't have to go even for 15 minutes. That would be good. Anything that you can do gentle. You can even just, if you are at home in a quarantine like this, I would say just start sitting less. So you answer the phone while you are standing and walking around your house. Maybe you are working in the computer, work while you are standing. Do just things that make you sit less. So that is always good. But yeah, if you are sick, you want to really give a rest. So don't push it too much. But it still needs to move somehow. Yeah, thank you very much all for joining. So if there is not any questions, I hope I brought to your house some of the most important tools and things like new things that you can start doing to improving your health. And also, I think Treehouse is going to share my information if anybody wants to contact me through my website. You can find all my contact information in there. I would be happy to see you in person in the future or talk to you in an online meeting. Thank you very much, everyone.